The Dick Brass Trails. They are some of the most remote, rugged, and elusive dirt bike trails in the world. And so is the man who single-handedly built them. Dick Brass, a real-life rocket scientist turned power plant engineer, gave up the lab coats and the clean room to live life from a camper and boldly go where no man has gone before, desert style. An enduro enthusiast discovered the Moab area while he was working on the space shuttle program in California, making regular junkets on long weekends. But his passion for the remote desert came with a wrong turn.
I was trying to find the dinosaur quarry, and I missed the left turn that takes you 6 miles out to the quarry, and kept going and going, went down Buckhorn Wash, went across the swinging bridge, kept going until I got to Muddy River, and I said, this is the place to go ride, and to hell with Moab.
So, when he had a chance to trade building rocket power for electric power, Dick took a position with the Huntington Power Plant in central Utah.
Since I had been riding around Moab and then down around the natural bridges for a couple of years while I was in California, you know, driving 14 hours overnight just to get there, I figured that was like almost like going to heaven.
As Dick settled into Utah, he loved the solitude of the desert, but noticed
there were no trail riders in Utah when I got here in 82, because there were no trails. So when I started building trails, then I had to take people out and show them that they could actually ride that kind of stuff.
But Dick had little interest in personally showing everyone where to ride, so he started finding trails and making them in what would become the legendary color-coded Dick Brass system.
The first trail system I made in 86, I used various colors. That's why they were painted those colors, and people still call it the Orange Trail, the Red Trail. They actually have names, but nobody ever uses them. I have to admit, I can't remember what they are right now.
Dick has been very meticulous in building highly technical single-track trails. He wanted them to be just so.
And then I did all my exploration on foot. So I was just hiking into canyons and up and down canyons and trying to find a way to get in and a way to get out.
Scott Wheeler and I, at one time, we actually moved the trail a little ways because it was kind of close to a camping area and people were getting on it by accident or whatever. So we kind of moved it, and he told us,
no. I build the trails, you ride the trails. You don't try to change the trails, you ride on the trail that I built.
At 88 years, the days of trail building are far in the rearview mirror for Dick. For all that he has worked on over the last four decades, one accomplishment stands out and always will.
People come from all around the world. They don't just come from 50 states, they come from other countries.
With another legend of the trail, I'm Stephen Heumann.